Making changes to your home takes a leap of faith, and I think it's time we convinced Mary that a few minor, well-thought-out adjustments could make a huge difference. Mary and Luke aren't going to do this separate bedroom scheme, so what are they going to do?
So the idea, I think, is to concentrate on the ground floor as a big social space. Instead of being little pokey rooms all separate, try to get a big sense of connected space, light through, but equally without becoming one vast kind of hall.
That sounds like a really good idea, and also a really good model for domestic space generally, because in a way, what they haven't done is the radical scheme of having two very separate spaces. And I like the delicate touch of just setting up somewhere where they can coexist quite happily without any big, grand architectural move. With work underway, Mary can't afford to hesitate. So I've brought her to a fantastic home that could make her rethink open-plan living. Hi, Mary. Hi, Luke.
Hi. How are you?
Piers.
How are you doing?
Good, good, good.
Good
nice
to see you.
Pleased to see you. Looking forward to today.
Good. So, what do you think?
Really, really like the outside and looking forward to seeing inside.
Yeah, it looks lovely.
This compact new build is a great example of what's becoming known as broken plan. So come on in.
It's very modern, but I actually really like it.
Broken plan is where an open space is loosely divided by partitions, furniture or lighting. There are very distinct zones and areas where you can imagine doing something different. I mean, there's a study there, and instead of having a wall and a door, there's just a glazed screen that implies a separation between it. To create broken plan space, you can use wider or taller non-standard doorways to open up views through your home without taking up walls or installing expensive beams. And repositioning furniture is a simple way you can create zones within a room. It's neither open plan or enclosed. It's sort of halfway between. There's this opening here, which works really well. So it's full height. You benefit from seeing the full length of the building.
Yeah, I can picture it as something like this, where it's quite split but open. If you want it to feel separate, you can make it feel separate. It is really open.
These look like very standard base units with a beautiful piece of melamine face ply on it. But then what's nice about this is that the floor goes right underneath it. Mm. So again, it adds to that sense of the space feeling bigger. By using simple tricks like lifting furniture off the floor or choosing a single colour for walls and floors, you can create a feeling of space. Feels like one building, yet there are these separate zones, and the zones aren't made with doors and walls, they're made by implying a separate area.
Do you think it's something that you'd think about doing
now? I think I would now, yeah. It would definitely work for us.
Mm.
Definitely.
See what that's like. Roof lights over the stairwell like this are a simple way to flood light into your home in what can traditionally be the gloomiest space. Well, I mean, this is a space that doesn't give you any more floor space in a house that isn't huge, and yet, for me, it feels essential.
Because you're a lot more conventional the way you think about how a property should be.
I suppose my mindset is that you have separate rooms, and now I see, actually, by opening up, it makes the space look much bigger.
You can also see that there are other ways to zone areas.
Oh, definitely. Yeah. Whether it's a floor level or a different material, I can see that.
The main thing would be that you can have it open, but still make it feel separate. It sounds cliche and like architecture speak, separate, but you know, but it can actually be done. And that I'd say that's the biggest thing, because Mum's quite rigid in her views, and so I reckon it's probably took down some of her boundaries in her head in terms of what we can do with the house.